Hello, this is Sasha from Motion Design School. Today I will show you how to create frame wireframe animation in Photoshop. You may ask, why Photoshop? There are so many other great software options for animation. My answer is simple. Sure, Photoshop doesn't provide the most comfortable animation process. It's starting to lag from the huge number of layers and has a very poor set of tools for animation. But it also has a few advantages. It's very comfortable for lining and coloring frames. It has a lot of tools for creating beautiful images. Personally, I often use it to add some subtle animation to an illustration. And there's so many people who create absolutely awesome stuff with this tool. In the first part of this video, I will show you how to create animation with a free AnimeDesign 2 plugin. I use it really often. It significantly speeds up my work process, since this is a panel that contains all the necessary functions. If you have any issues with installing it, check out the timecode where I'm making everything with standard Photoshop tools. Link to the manual and installation file of the AnimeDesign 2 are in the description. And now, let's get started. To start using AnimeDesign panels, simply go to Window, Extensions, AnimeDesign 2. Now let's open the timeline panel. You can open it really quickly using this button of the plugin. Then click Create Video Timeline. Now we have a timeline pretty similar to the one from After Effects. Next, I have set up a frame rate. For that, go to the timeline menu, select Set Timeline Frame Rate, and set it to 12 frames per second. It's the most comfortable and less time-consuming frame rate. After that, click this button of AnimeDesign panel, which will create a new video group on the timeline, and a layer panel. Here you can arrange your layers, which are also the animation frames as well, in one line in a way that doesn't increase the timeline high. As an example, I will create a jumping ball animation. First, I will draw the keyframes. To create a new frame, simply click this button on the AnimeDesign panel. You can see a similar button right next to this one, but it creates a layer that is 2 frames long. This is really comfortable if you're drawing contours. I will turn on onion skins to be able to see previous frame. Keys are ready, timing is defined. Now let's draw in betweens. For convenience, I will paint the following and the previous frame in different colors, using this button on the panel. In order to not get confused, you can make keyframes and backgrounds with different colors as well. Alright, this is how to create animations in Photoshop with the help of AnimeDesign 2 plugin. And now let's consider the standard way of creating animation in Photoshop, in case you weren't able to install AnimeDesign for any reason. First of all, let's open the timeline. Go to Window, Timeline. Next, in the panel that has appeared, select Video Timeline. After that, set the timeline frame rate. Go to Menu, Set Timeline Frame Rate. Now let's start animating. First of all, I'm going to create a video group and place all the animation frames there. For that, click the arrow next to the frame icon and select New Video Group. Then I will create keyframes for my animation. To create a new frame, I just click this icon and then decrease its length to 1 frame. And then just copy it again and again. It's a bit inconvenient, since each new frame has a length of the full timeline, and we have to shorten them again and again. But in general, this approach works great for creating keyframes and breakdowns. Also, we will need onion skins. Go to the timeline menu and click Enable Onion Skins. You'll find its setting below. Done. Now let's move to drawing in-betweens. Unfortunately, there is no option of automatically recoloring the nearest frames. If you want the previous and the following frames to have different colors, you have to recolor them manually. For that, double-click the layer and in the Layer Style window, select the Color Overlay option. Select Normal in the Blend mode and choose the color you need. You can also record all these actions to Photoshop Action. I would say you can do without recoloring the frames, But in case you have a complex drawing with a bunch of lines, it's really hard to distinguish where the previous and the next frames are. That's it! Well, here are all the main differences between AnimDesign and standard approach. At the first sign, there is no drastic differences. Functions are the same. But everything is much faster with AnimDesign. There is no need to go to the menu, select settings, apply effects, trim layers, tune and all the onion skins options via the menu. So, if you decided to do animation in Photoshop, AnimDesign is essential. Now, let's start the cleanup process. Photoshop has a pretty cool feature, it's called video layers. To create a video layer, click Layer, Video Layer, New Blank Video Layer. Its advantage is that you don't need to create a new layer each time. You can simply draw on each frame. To make the brush move smoothly, I've changed the smoothing parameter to 100%. That's it. The animation is finished. Now let's talk about render. Everything is easy here. Go to the timeline menu and click Render Video. You can select a destination folder, format, video or file sequence, size and frame rate. To render your animation into GIF format, go to File, Export, Save for Web or use the Ctrl-Alt-Shift-S shortcut. Select GIF format, set up the setting and click the Save button. You can also import the file to After Effects and continue to work on it there. That's how it works. That is so far. You can practice by recreating the same animation, but if it's too simple for you, add some detail to the ball. For instance, eyes, dust that rises when it hits the ground, or color. Thanks for watching. Like, share, leave your comment. What do you think about creating animation in Photoshop? Do you use it for this purpose, or is it the first time you heard about it? Follow the Motion Design School and me on Instagram. Bye!